everyone. It's Ms. Pneumatic. Today, we are going to learn about drain. What's a drain? Drain means to cause the water, liquid, to run out. In this sense, a drain is a device for discharging liquids, such as water. Then, when do we use it? In order to generate compressed air necessary to operate the pneumatic system, an air compressor must force air into a storage tank and increase the pressure. Air compressing generates heat inside. This heat travels through the pipes, and as it cools again, it generates moisture. Not only that, moisture can be generated depending on the temperature of the operating system's environment. Moisture travels through the pneumatic hoses and tubing and enters various devices, causing rapid corrosion and premature failure. To prevent this, we install an air filter and a drain in the pneumatic system to filter and discharge moisture or any other foreign substances. Did you get the importance of drains? The drains we use can be broadly classified into two. I also mentioned this in my previous video about air filters. The two types are manual and automatic. Literally, manual drain is a method of manually discharging moisture and foreign substances, while the automatic drain is done vice versa. Today, we will learn about the manual drain. With manual drain, you can clear moisture and foreign substances in a variety of ways. One of them is to turn the handle and press a push button. Or, you can remove the case from the body and let the substances inside drain out. Today, we're going to take a look at the structure and operation principle of manual drain controlled by the handle. This manual drain locks the draining process by turning the handle to the right, or you can do it the other way by turning the handle to the left. Let's take a closer look at the structure. Manual drain controlled by the handle consists of a valve housing, a valve, a handle, and nuts. I'm going to show you how these components work one by one. As the compressed air passes through the air filter, moisture and foreign substances accumulate in the lower bowl. Once it reaches an adequate amount, all you need to do is turn the handle to the left to drain the moisture. By doing so, the screw inside will raise the manual drain valve. When a gap is formed in the valve, the moisture discharges through the hole at the center. Once the moisture is completely cleared out, turn the manual handle to the right to lower the valve. Now that we explored how a manual drain works, let me give you some precautions when using the device. Every operator should check the drain frequently and undergo a draining process when moisture reaches an appropriate amount. If you miss this process and leave the drain to accumulate moisture inside, the moisture flows back into the outlet without being filtered. If you fail to filter moisture, what would be the meaning of using an air filter and a drain? That's why it is very important to discharge moisture regularly to take advantage of using a filter. Another thing is that, sometimes, the operator may find it bothersome to do the process manually, leaving the drain open. In this case, be careful, as the compressed air passing through the filter may be leaked outside through the drain. Now, let me summarize the strengths and weaknesses of a manual drain. The strength of using a manual drain is that you can check the amount of moisture by yourself and drain it at the desired time. You can open or close the drain at your free will as well. Even if some compressed air is wasted, you can leave the drain open if you want to drain the moisture from time to time. Unlike automatic drain, you can lower the operation cost by making good use of the manual drain. On the other hand, the weakness is that the operator has to check and empty the drain regularly. If a large amount of moisture accumulates inside, the moisture filtered through the air filter will flow directly into the system, causing device failure. That's it for today. We quickly looked through the definition of a drain, the structure of a manual drain, and its strengths and weaknesses. In the next video, we will learn about the two types of auto drain, differential pressure and float. If this video helped you a bit, don't forget to subscribe and like. If you have any questions, write them in the comments below. I'll bring you more useful information next time. Bye! Miss Pneumatic Channel is working together with KCC Precision.